this specimen here, we've got a really nice dissection of the facial nerve. We can see the origin of the facial nerve here, and it's coming out, and this branch here is going to be the auriculopalpebral, because it's going to the palpebra, as well as this is the rostral auricular going to the ear. Okay, so this is the palpebral branch. And then we have the dorsal buccal, which is crossing the cheek right here. And then down here, we have the ventral buccal branch. Okay, so the dorsal and the ventral buccal branches are going to go to the muscles of the face. Remember, the facial nerve is what allows us to make faces. Okay, so it's motor to the superficial muscles of the head. Okay, so we had the ventral buccal, the dorsal buccal, and the auriculopalpebral. Okay, this structure here is the duct from the parotid gland. Okay, see, we reflected the parotid gland here. We see here, if we go rostral to the auriculopalpebral, we find this nice artery here, which is the superficial temporal. And then deep to that, we find some branches. These are the auriculotemporal branches of the mandibular nerve, which comes off the trigeminal nerve. Okay? So let's now follow the arteries. So here we have our common carotid coming up with the vagosympathetic trunk dorsal to it. Okay, we can see here that the vagosympathetic trunk leaves. We're going to have it separate into the vagus nerve, and it's going to have a swelling, which is the nodose ganglia. And then this ganglia here is going to be the cranial cervical ganglia, which then postsynaptic nerves that are sympathetic are then going to go to the head from here. Okay, we're going to see a branch coming off the vagus, coming down here, and going to the larynx. That's going to be the cranial laryngeal nerve. That's going to do innervation to the cricothyroideus muscle, as well as sensory innervation to the inner surface, the mucosa of the larynx. We see here an artery coming off with a very nice swelling right here. This is the carotid sinus, which you remember is a baroreceptor for blood pressure. So this is the internal carotid artery. Just beyond that, coming off, is the occipital artery. Okay. Somewhere about here, we should find a little branch. Here we do. Coming off here, going to the larynx. That's going to be the cranial laryngeal artery. We continue this way, and we have a branch that comes off. Let's go over to this side. Okay, we've got a branch coming off here that is coursing with this big nerve. This big nerve is the hypoglossal nerve. And this branch, this arterial branch here, is going to be the lingual artery. After the lingual artery comes off, we have another branch up here, which we can see better right here. So this branch here is going to be the facial artery. Notice it's coming along here. It's going to go to the structures of the face. It's going to give off a branch right here, which is the sublingual artery. Okay. So after that internal carotid came off, we continued as the external carotid. So we continue up here as the external carotid. We're giving off a caudal auricular branch. And then we turn here. Giving off our superficial temporal and then the main artery. Here we can see it well on this one that the external carotid gives off this superficial temporal and then continues here as the maxillary. Okay? Let's see what else we can find on this guy. Oh, here's really nicely those pterygoid muscles from this inner surface. Look at these other nerves here. Let's see what we can find. Here's another nerve that is just lateral to the cranial cervical ganglia. And that's going to be the glossopharyngeal nerve. And we come back here. We find another nerve coming off. Here is the accessory nerve, which innervates some of the muscles of the neck and shoulder. And as we said, this nerve here going to the tongue, this big nerve is the hypoglossal nerve. Hypoglossal is going to do innervation to the muscles of the tongue.